Yo, this is Deontay the Bronze Bummer Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Face facts, what up?
RealFansRealTalk.com, where Arthur Domus, Trip Young, and intern Tom Fredda, white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter. Tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda. Certified cosign. You know what I'm about, son. RealFansRealTalk.com. I'm out. One. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com.
What's going on? Welcome back. Another live episode of Real Fans Real Talk. I'm in a great mood this week because the Australian Open is going on right now. My wifey for lifey, baby boo, Serena, is back in action, you know, coming for her next Grand Slam title. So I'm excited about that. Plus, we welcoming back Pop today. Y'all know the past couple of weeks, y'all done seen the GoFundMe campaign up there for Pop on the show. We've been talking about it, but Pop is officially back with us. First time in 2017, so we got to welcome Pop back. And we got a whole lot of sports to get into. Plus, we got some special guests in here, too. But before we get into that, let me introduce my co-host, the one and only Mark the Statman Skevich. What's going on, man?
It's great to be back for another live episode of Real Fans Real Talk. Great to have Pop back. Pop doing the little pop dance. I don't know what that is, but I like it. It's cool. Good to have you back. We love you. Of course, I'm rocking my Lionel Richie tonight. Is it me you're looking for? Obviously, you're looking for me. You tune into Real Fans Real Talk, but very excited that the Cowgirls took the L. Mm-hmm. You know, couldn't have the Giants win, but at least the Cowgirls lost to the Packers as well. And the Cowgirls fans out there, it's like, oh, well, we lost by a lot less than you did.
So that makes you the first best loser? Like, who cares? Like, you still lost.
But you lost to us twice, too, during the season. So it's like, yeah, you have a better record. Yeah, you lost by, you know, less, but you still haven't won a Super Bowl in over 20 years. So, yeah. I mean, and the Giants have won two, plus you lost two, and it's just... It's just great to rub it into the Cowgirls fans,
yeah.
The memes across the internet, you know, not even just Giants fans, all across the country. You either love the Cowgirls or you hate them, and there's a lot more people hating on them because the Cowgirls fans are the worst. But
they definitely are. So I'm very happy about that one. I like the Ezekiel Elliott Jordan crying face meme because they had one over his face and one over his stomach since he likes to wear his jersey above his belly button. So they had two. But yeah, I was enjoying this entire weekend of football. My man Tom Too Cool is back and going back to another AFC Championship game. He got the Steelers this week. I know you said you rocking with the Steelers in the upset. But I don't know if they gonna go into Foxborough and take my man Tom Too Cool down. They got a lot to prove for me to believe that, and I don't think that's gonna happen. I don't know if Roethlisberger and Antonio Brown and Le'Veon Bell could do that. It's gonna be real crazy up there. And you know Antonio Brown, he's still doing Facebook Live videos in the locker room, so I don't know if that's gonna mess him up. Yeah. You know they've been talking about it in the media now, so he's going down this week. That's it. It's over for Antonio Brown. He's gonna have two catches for 13 yards, and that's gonna be it.
We had George from Queens wrote in. Do you guys think the Antonio Brown scandal is going to be a distraction for the Steelers? And maybe not the Steelers, but when wide receivers have media distractions, apparently it doesn't pay too well for them, as we've seen with Odell Beckham and Shepard with a bunch of key drops over there with the Giants. So I don't think it'll be too much of a distraction for the team. I don't really think it's going to distract Antonio Brown. And you got, you know, the triple threat of the Steelers, Big Ben, Le'Veon Bell, and Antonio Brown. That's a lot of weapons there. Patriots don't have Gronk. Patriots are still great, They are the favorite to win, but I'm feeling an upset across the board. I think that somehow the Steelers are going to pull it off.
The only way I could agree with you on that upset is if they were playing the Giants. That's about it. But I don't think the Steelers have it to go into Foxborough and beat Tom Brady or to get past Belichick's mind. Like, you know, I mean, it's gonna be a great game. But I just think that, you know, Tom Brady got a lot of get back to get, you know, after being suspended this year. You know, and then, you know, your boy Roger Goodell, he's ducking him. He don't even want to go to Foxborough no more. He don't want to go up there for the championship game. So he's not even going to watch the game live in the stadium.
Why would you go to that game out of the two when, you know you're hated? So you're not doing anybody any favors going into Foxborough. And plus Atlanta, you know, it will be the last game at the Georgia Dome. So that's kind of a, you know, somewhat of an event. It's not anything like, you know, a Boston Garden or anything close to that. But at the same time, you know, it's still a closed, the last game in a stadium. So, plus, the reality is he doesn't want to get booed.
Okay, yeah, that's...
We really know what the real reason
now,
is.
Now we're getting down to it.
I mean, I said that at the beginning, but I'm saying some excuses on that.
Okay, all right, because
it's
right,
the last right. game in the Georgia Dome.
And okay, you know, I'm going to go with that. I'm going to let you get that. It was the last game in the Georgia Dome. But you know it was not going to be good for Roger Goodell if he went up to Foxborough. He can watch them at the Super Bowl. When they play.
I mean, he might not have a choice if the Patriots do go there. There's a lot of people that want to see Roger Goodell hand Tom Brady the Super Bowl, especially after all the deflategate.
Oh, that would be amazing. If that happens, you got to turn and give the trophy to Tom Brady after everything that went down, the suspension, deflategate, all the back and forth, the courts and whatnot, and then to turn around in the same season he got suspended in, you got to give him that trophy. That would be amazing. That would be poetry in motion right there.
Yeah, I mean, not a Patriots fan, not a Brady fan, but I think I would find that funny if the Patriots do end up winning, no question about that. And it's really because, you know, how long the Deflategate was dragged out for. It was so many years. I'm not even going to talk about it anymore. Point is accomplished there with that one. It's got enough media coverage as it is, but it would be hilarious to see that. I mentioned last game at the Georgia Dome. It's probably going to be a victory. The Falcons played the Packers in the Georgia Dome earlier this season, and it was a shootout nail biter, 33-32, which means they can get the job done against the pack got their injuries, especially in the secondary, and with Matty Ice, front runner for MVP, going out there and getting it done against the Seattle defense. I think he's going to be able to definitely put up a lot of points in that game against the Packers.
Yeah, I mean, I'm picking the Falcons to win, but we keep saying each week, you know, the injuries, I don't know if this is going to be the week for the Packers, and they keep losing guys every week, but they keep winning.
Jordy Nelson was out, and I said last week, if Jordy Nelson plays, they beat the Cowgirls, but they might not be able to beat him without it.
Yeah.
I mean, it really did come down to the wire, but...
But they're still winning, even with these injuries. It's like, it's amazing, you know, watching Aaron Rodgers and what he's able to do. And I'm not even going to give all the credit to Aaron Rodgers because, you know, those guys, I mean, they almost gave it up. But you know what? The defense came through in the end, and they were able to, you know, to hold off the Cowgirls. Now, they lost another defensive player. So, I don't know if they'll be able to keep up with Julio Jones because he's just having an amazing year right now. You know, so we got to wait and see. But I'm picking the Falcons to go to the Super Bowl and play the Patriots.
He's on a whole nother level than, you know, Dez Bryant. And Dez Bryant had a big game. So.
Yeah. So, and you know, I think Julio's going to
have a huge game.
Yeah, he's gonna do his numbers. And I think the Falcons will at least get a win at the last game in the Georgia Dome and make their way off to the Super Bowl. I was, you know, very excited about this game because I just wanted to see, you know, in the Seahawks game whether or not they were actually going to play nothing but Future songs the whole time to mess with Russell Wilson. But it didn't matter because they pretty much had the Seahawks number.
Did you pay attention to the music?
I didn't pay attention to the music the entire game, but I do, you know, I do know that Future sent his son
during the commercial breaks anyway.
He sent his son a Falcons jersey after the Falcons beat up on the Seahawks. So I do know at least that much.
Well, that was nice.
Now, I mean, it was a gift, you know, it was a little partying gift, you know, for his son and whatnot. You know, hopefully Russell Wilson doesn't have to look at the jersey too much. But you know, Matty Ice, great job. Like I said, he is the front runner for the MVP now. And the way he's playing, he's looking like he definitely will be getting that trophy. I think they're getting past the Packers.
You have three potential MVP candidates in the final four, and then you have Ben Roethlisberger. I mean, you got a hell of a quarterback matchup in both games.
Yeah.
Pretty much. You got two, you know, three sure Hall of Famers and most likely four. I mean, if Matty Ice continues his career the way he's going.
Yeah.
So it's probably one of the best Final Four and quarterbacks we've seen.
In a little while, yeah. You're right. So we're gonna wait to see this weekend is going down. You got the Steelers and the Falcons. I got the Falcons and the Patriots, and we're gonna see what's going on with that. And you know, really quick, we're gonna jump into a little bit of basketball before we bring our guest out, cause your man Melo, he's going through some things right now. I don't know what's up. He had to sit down with the Zen Master. He said he still wants to be a Knick, but he did give a list of three teams that he would waive his trade clause for. So, you know, what you think, Statman? It's just your squad. It's your Knickerbockers. What's up? What's going on?
I'm okay with it. I mean, I never liked the fact that we gave up as much as we did for Melo. I've been, you know, adamant about that since day one, that if he really wanted to win a chip here, he could have waited till the end of the season, become a free agent. We wouldn't have to give up anything. And if we had to make cap room, we could have traded those pieces for picks or something, as opposed to giving up just about all we have to bring him on. Now, granted, you know, the following year, you know, since we still had a lot of pieces, you know, Stoudemire, we were second in the Eastern Conference. But after that, it's been horrendous. So, and on the flip side, the Nuggets, they actually got better without Carmelo Anthony, because without him, you actually play team basketball, and you got to play team basketball in order to win. So, you know, that'll get you through some games, and they do a good job of playing team basketball other than the fourth quarter. We've talked about it with Eric Sanchez, our blogger for Real Fans Real Talk from Petro Home Services. He was saying the same thing, that, you know, Melo just goes back to isolation, and in the fourth quarter, is pretty much in his hands, and you know, if he makes all those, you know, difficult shots, which he's capable of doing, then we'll win the game. But if he doesn't, we won't, and that's what ends up happening.
And you guys are back under 500 right now, correct?
That is correct.
I'm gonna get the numbers right. So they're back under 500. That's a fact, definitely. All right, Derrick Rose is coming up missing. They don't know if Melo's gonna be a Knick anymore.
Missed one game. Come on.
I'm just saying, Stan, man, this is not looking good. I hope they get it together by the All-Star break, man. I really wanted to see them play the Cavs.
It was all good just a month ago.
It really was. Everything was good, man. Y'all was at 500. Y'all was climbing, and then now, you know, just back to same old.
Maybe
Knicks,
the
man.
Shirt was for Derrick Rose. Hello, is it me?
maybe it was. You know, but what are you gonna do at this point, man? But I do want to All-Star game real quick.
Which three teams even?
Cavs, Clippers, and I forget the third team. I don't think it was the Bulls. Mm-hmm. Cavs, Clippers, and I think the third team was in the Western Conference. But. You know, I don't want to.
I mean, Blake Griffin and Chris Paul are free agents next year, so I wouldn't want to trade.
That's it. Yeah.
The Cavs, like, will they get JR and Chum back?
Yeah, that's. I mean, I'm cool with that trade, actually. If that's what the Cavs would have to give up,
JR
and Chum.
That's not what I would want for Melo.
No, I'm pretty sure they'd have to give up Kevin Love.
Yeah, Kevin Love and maybe another beast to go with that.
Yeah, but I mean, the Cavs
would actually be okay with that, too, and I'm sure Kevin Love, you know, being the third wheel over there, he's not exactly putting up the numbers that he used to when he was in Minnesota. So,
yeah. Nah, I'm good. I'm good with the Cavs team. You keep that negativity in New York, all right, with your Knickerbockers. The Cavs are set. They just got Kyle Korver. You know, once J.R. Smith comes back, they're pretty much going straight to the NBA Finals. So
you don't want Melo on your Cavs?
I mean, not if we got to give up Kevin Love. I like Kevin Love on the team. But this thing, you know, with Kevin Love, plays well, you know, pretty much against every team. He just has matchup problems with Golden State. That's the one issue they have. But we know that the Cavs can beat Golden State. But we know they can beat Golden State. So, you know, they've done it before, so they can do it again. So I'm not worried about that. But with Melo, you know, I don't know if Melo has that championship caliber, that heart of a champion. I just
definitely don't think he does.
He had it on the college level. He had it in the Olympics. But when it comes down to
level, I'll give him. But the Olympics, that's not, you know, when you're surrounded by
all stars and future
Hall of Famers. I'm not, you know, giving you that. Like,
now, are you?
That's like saying Karl Malone had championship.
Yeah, well,
because he played on the Dream Team.
Yeah, that's true. That's true too. But you mentioned the All Stars. Russell Westbrook, who's having, you know, one of the best seasons we've seen in a long time. Averaging a triple-double right now, first person since Oscar Robertson, if he can actually hold it up for the rest of the season. But he will not be starting in the All-Star game because they gave the second guard spot to Steph Curry, and of course James Harden got the first guard spot. Should Steph Curry be starting in the All-Star game? Golden State Warriors are in first place.
I got to say yes, because I think it's an insult either way. When you look at snubs, somebody's got to get snubbed, and you're talking about the two-time reigning MVP and, you know, first-ever unanimous MVP, and he's on the first-place team. Yes, Russell Westbrook was more deserving of the MVP award than Steph Curry, but I don't think he deserves more of an all-star. That's like if LeBron James was having a bad season and they, you know, put Paul George ahead of him because Paul George was having a better season. You kind of can't really do that with the All-Star game. Now, the fans don't have 100% of the vote like they used to, but obviously that, you know, was a factor in it.
I mean, honestly, I would like to see Westbrook start. I mean, the man is averaging a triple-double right now. And Steph is not having a Steph year. He's having a little bit of a down year. Durant really just came in and kind of just took over everything. So I would have liked to see Westbrook get the starting spot. I know James Harden. You have to give it to James Harden because he's got the Rockets in third place right now, and he's almost averaging the triple double. He's got about 14 or 15 triple doubles on the season right now. You know, but I knew they were going to give it to Steph just because Golden State is in first place. But I think it should have went to Westbrook. But, you know, fans, you can't really expect too much out of the fans because, I mean,
I'm not too mad at that. It's not it's Steph Curry. It's not, you know, like he got snubbed for Chris Paul or something.
Yeah, like somebody like something like that. So, yeah, I can live with it since it's Steph Curry and they are in first place. But, you know, I just think the season that Westbrook is having, averaging triple-double, he should have definitely been in there. Plus, I just like how his reaction after the game when he realized that Saja Pachulia kind of stepped over him and looked down on him after he knocked him down on that play. He was like, you know, I'm going to have to see him on that one. So I like that, you know, but definitely looking forward to this year's All-Star game because I really want to see how this thing is gonna play out. And just as, you know, that matchup, you know, with OKC and Golden State, I got to see those guys go back and forth. Westbrook and Durant, you know, really balled out last night. You know, clearly Golden State is the better team, no question about that. So I don't expect, you know, OKC to get a win over them, but you never know.
You know, I mean, they also got a win against the Cavs recently too.
They did get a win against the Cavs. I mean, I think the saying goes, "The sun even shines on a dog's butt some days," right? So you gotta, you know, they were due for one.
They are the Sunshine State, so
exactly, they was due for one. They lost four in a row. They lost, you know, after being up three games to one.
That's actually Florida, but
in the finals. But I see where you're going with that.
Yeah, you acknowledged it for some reason. Appreciate.
You know, I was gonna let you rock. You know,
Golden State kind of, you know.
Yeah, but it sounded good, so yeah. I'm gonna let you rock out with that one. But listen, we got some guests that's covered on, you know, from Streetline, some really good movie producers and directors, and a good friend of both of ours, and Vera. She's gonna be joining us in a second, and You guys know we talk about all her movies because we done been to see, either we've seen them in the theaters or, you know, we've watched them online, but we always support Vera and whatever she's doing. And we're actually going to play you a clip from one of her most recent projects. And when we come back, she will be joining us on the set with one of the stars of the film that Statman is also starring in.
I was trying to build a suspense up for you,
Statman. You know, so it's about to go down in a second. So if you guys can get that video clip ready for us.
The movie debut of yours truly. Now, we played it before on the show, but now we're going to talk to some of the other, the star of the show, because I'm not the star, surprisingly. and Vera, of course, the creator of Streetline. So you've probably seen this clip before if you watch Real Fans Real Talk, but here it is again, Ppressed battle rap movie. And when we come back, we'll have the folks from Streetline.
Want to see me?
I'm seeing
what I do. I know my paperwork is good.
Ain't nothing. Sal, just want to talk to you real quick. Mad nerves for no reason. We wanted the off you to be done already. You chill here. You come on, let's go.
You're gonna start your own battle rap league.
Right. I mean, like, we so late with this. You got URL, we got Boss Chick Battle League, we got Think Straight. I mean, come on, it's out of here with that, right?
I know, but we're gonna do things different. We're gonna up the ante a bit. Recording contract with Falcon Records. You're gonna open up for the top hip hop artist out there for a year and be the new face of Falcon Records. And we're gonna pay you $500,000 untaxed dollars. I put the money in a book bag because I know you guys don't carry briefcases, so this is more your style.
What's this supposed to mean?
Whoa, calm down now. Don't get all sensitive on me. You know your people over there wearing book bags with their pants sagging down to their knees, showing off their underwear. There's one catch though. You gotta do this in a week.
I'm supposed to throw a battle league in a week.
I don't know, and I don't care. It's your time. Showtime. Take care. I'll see you later. I want him watched.
Right. Welcome back. If you guys are just joining us on Real Fans Real Talk, that was a little snippet from the movie Ppressed, Streetline original film. And we are here with Streetline in the building. Miss Vera, it's such a pleasure to have you on the program with us. Showtime as well. Yeah. You're starting it. You're doing it, man. You're doing it, brother. Let's get it. What's going on? First of all, just tell us how this movie came about.
Because I do a lot of, I shoot a lot. I shoot a lot of videos and stuff, and I see a lot of rappers, and basically, facially, everyone's a rapper. And they needed exposure, and I told them, you know, a lot of them sell their music outside for $1, $5, and I told them I'm not gonna play it, I'm not gonna listen. I said, because they're not mainstream rappers. And I said, in order for you to become famous, or even noticeable, you have to be in something for someone to recognize you. So I got together with my son, Ricardo Cordero. He's one of the main directors, and Showtime, and we came up with Ppressed. And actually, it's oppressed. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just the O out of it, because a lot of rappers are either oppressed or depressed. Mm. So, yeah.
How's the feedback been?
It's great. It's really, really great. When I do a movie, either I put it out in the theater or I just release it to the world, they snatch it up and they go with it. And I think they're just noticing that they can be more than just a rapper. Yeah. I'm getting into the lives of battle rappers. You know, it's not all about the hip hop and this, this and that. It's about the stories. Mm-hmm. So we have to, you know, it's like, you know, everybody has these reality shows, Real Housewives of Atlanta, et cetera, et cetera. Well, this is a real life story, you mm-hmm. know. It's just, we just got you guys acting it out, yeah. you know.
And so how'd you get involved with Vera?
Oh, man. I used to see Vera at every single celebrity event there is. Every time I turn around, I look, I see her. It got to the point where, like, if she wasn't there, it didn't seem right. Mm. You know, and if she was there, I was in the right place. So, you know, I had my DVDs with, you know, all the mainstream artists on the cover. Mm-hmm. And I'm showing her, look, check this out, because I respect her hustle. And she was working with other people at the time. And I said, damn, if I ever had that slot, what? I do what I'm told and well, be quiet.
You sure enough got it. You got the lead role.
Mm-hmm.
How was production, though? For you as the lead, how was production?
Oh, it's crazy. Like, working with V is crazy. She ain't going to tell you how you're doing. She's going to tell you, like, listen, you the main character. Don't let them outwork you. Do what you got to do. You got to figure it out. They give you direction, but it's up to you to bring it, you know?
Yeah.
He know.
Well, I'd like to say something. I just want to say that I'm a director in training, and I think I keep telling people that all the time because I don't have the best equipment. I don't have the worst equipment, but, I'm learning every day. I don't like people who are sagged or people who are so much in show business. Mm-hmm. I want to work with newcomers. And, I put the ads all over. I say, hey, you want to try this out? Try it. You know, and I break ground with them. I get them from being, like nervous. If you want to be a performer, entertainer, then you have to entertain.
Yeah.
You know, and some of them find out that they're not entertainers at all.
First of all, I just want to say, because she's being very humble right now, mm-hmm. because she's about 5-6 movies in right now.
Yeah, six.
So stop. Now we
and listen. Awards.
A couple of awards in. What about 3-4 awards in?
Yeah.
Okay. So come on. Now we got and I really enjoy all our movies. And one thing I do love is that I like how, when you have let's say a Tyler Perry, who. You know, he supports the people that support him, and you see a lot of similar faces in his films. And I like that you continue to give opportunities to people that have supported your projects and been there, as actors or, whatever, a cameraman or just any part of the production team. You keep them around and keep giving opportunities to people. So I definitely admire that.
Thank you. Well, on the set, it's actually myself and my son.
Mm-hmm.
And you've seen it. You would just see myself and my son. My son is the cameraman. He's the light, lighter. You know, he does all the light, boom, et cetera, et cetera. I'm actually the one that points. I'm the one that makes sure all the equipment is picked up because sometimes you know, I always ask for PAs and everything, and they say they'll come and they never show up. So yeah. We just do the movies. We just do them.
And you guys are definitely completing projects, which is the most important thing. You know, a lot of people start, but they don't finish. So the fact that you continue to complete projects, that's the best part of it.
Well, speaking of Tyler Perry, I don't know him personally, but on Facebook, someone asked them a question. And it was a question I was thinking about myself. This is when I did Chicken, my first movie.
Mm-hmm.
The person said, hey, I want to do this, I want that, I don't have this money, yada, yada. And he's been holding this project for like 3 years. So Tyler Perry just said, just do it. Mm. Just do it because content goes quickly. You can have an idea today and someone has it out tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So I don't wait for anything.
Yeah.
If I don't have the best atmosphere, if I don't have the best people, I'm still going to do it. Mm. When you do your movies, it's a form of copyright, you know? It's a form of copyright. I copyright it no matter what with the Library of Congress. I do that no matter what. But second of all, I also put it out in the public because with all the bootlegging, That's what they did with my first movie. They bootlegged it.
Yeah. And well, that's when you know you came up, when they bootlegged your stuff.
Yeah.
You're doing something right. Mm-hmm.
But what got me is when my movie was shown overseas. Mm. And when I started seeing that, people said, I've seen your movie overseas. I said, how you seen the movie over there? And I said, well, they would pick it up from Harlem. And Harlem is like the mainstream if you want to get anything, anything. And they picked up my movie from Harlem and they made their copies and sent it all over. And it was a wrap.
Wow. There you go. Mm-hmm. So basically you're worldwide now. That's what you're saying.
Yeah, I'm worldwide, but it's not that I'm humble. I think I wrote it on my website. I have a website. It's the same thing, streetlinevideo.com. Mm-hmm. I wrote it on my website, like memories don't leave like people do. And I'm only here to create memories. Mm. It's very important. You know, we have, like a lot of like rappers, singers, et cetera, they want you to buy their content, but people remember the visual. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They will always remember the visual. Songs, you'll say, hey, who made that song? Or whatever. But the visual, they'll say, they can point your face to someone else. Mm-hmm. You know, so I create memories. And I mean, it is what it is.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Now, are you working on your next project now?
Yes. Actually, Mark here is in.
You back at us?
Yeah, he's actually Mark is Sal. Sal is a big time record producer.
Okay.
And the music to date, and this is real life. Music companies are not making money because everyone has their own record label.
Yeah.
And everyone finds a way to distribute their music the way it is. So Mark here, like I said, he plays Sal. He's looking for a way to tap into that business and take over it and create some kind of hostile environment. And when he creates this hostile environment, his stocks go up. And this is how he makes his money. But that's one of the projects. So what you saw was episode one. And episode one is an hour and 40-something minutes. Mm-hmm. It's almost like The Get Down. The Get Down, it has six.
And then it'll be smaller after that. It'll be shorter. Or will it still be?
Well, it's like that. Instead of doing 13 episodes, mm-hmm. I just rather do six episodes.
Okay.
But they're full feature. Just to keep people watching it. And each character has their own story. After a while, the characters will die out. The ones who are very important will stay. You know, some people will die off.
Okay.
You know, some people will phase out. But don't worry, Sal is going to be there.
I was going to say, sorry, Sean. Like, that's a joke, but I know he's going.
He's going to stay. Good.
You made a stat, man. You're going to be in a recurring role. That's a great thing. Showtime, you good, too. You up in there, man.
That's a spoiler. The fans might want to see you get popped.
Nah. We need, you know, like, in every movie, every show, you have to have a bad guy. You have to have a bad guy. You have to have a good guy. You have to have every type of person so your fans can follow. Mm-hmm. And they love them all.
Yeah.
And when I get the feedback, like on YouTube, I get a lot of feedback. And the fans will actually, say, well, why did he do this? And, oh, I hate this guy. Or, this guy was whack. And, I get a lot of feedback from them. And it makes the movie better. So right now, our second episode, we start shooting in, I think, about 2 or 3 weeks.
Okay.
And we go by pieces. But also, we're doing Rodent. And that's, Rodin is a web series, a soap opera. This is a web series. Mm-hmm. Soap opera is the definition of a hood rat, so it's called Rodin. Mm. And it's really, really good. We already had our first episode, and it has a lot of views.
When I tell you the things that's going on in that, it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
man. And I wanted to say, like, I watched all her other movies. I've been in there. I've been in some of them, but this is the most I've been in one movie. Mm-hmm. But what I liked about the movie was that the movies are different. And I'm looking at the movie, I'm looking at the script, and I'm like, because you know I come from that world, the battle rap world. I know every single battle rapper. Like, I got battle rap DVDs, battle rap interviews. I own my own battle rap league, all that. And then I'm just reading
this. And I'm like, yo, this is crazy. This is bananas. It got to the point where, like, we did it before the battle rappers did it. Yeah. You know, and I caught some heat from that too. They like, oh, Showtime, you did. I'm like, I didn't write this. I'm just acting.
Yeah.
That's it. You know what I'm saying?
Play the character, that's all.
Yeah, but she tapped into something special, and especially because, like, the characters, some of the characters in it are real battle rappers, and I own a real battle rap league. It's like, that's like a portion of my life, for real.
Who's an actual battle rapper that's in the film?
Wow. Meezy.
Blitz Bug Out. They battle for my league.
Oh, wow. It's what's Bane.
Showtime Battle League.
Okay.
Yeah, Bane. Wow. There's so many rappers.
Yeah, but Blitz Bug Out, I was a real battle rapper.
Actually, everyone who performed, everyone who rapped in that segment, in those segments, are real battle rappers.
Okay.
And they're just going lightly. What's his name? What's the guy's name?
Which one?
The one that plays, I forgot his name. Oh, I forgot this one. D-Boogs. D-Boogs is a battle rapper.
But D-Boogs, he's from Wu-Tang.
Yeah, Wu-Tang out.
He's affiliated to Wu-Tang.
I have to say one other thing. Mm-hmm. One of the main stars, show is a star, but we have Mikey
Destruction.
Mikey D. Destruction.
From Queens.
Queens
legend.
He's an old school artist, hip-hop artist. MC Sham and LL. And
If you see Vlad got an interview and he asking Shams about him. And he said, you want to talk Queens? Mikey Destruction. He ran with LL, he battled Melly Mel. Mm-hmm. He's like one of the top people from Queens. So like to have him in the movie, crazy.
That's the one that opens up the one who's with the crackheaded sister and stuff like that.
Yeah, but we got real battle rappers in there.
It's deep. And after a while, it will stray away from the rap part because we really want to concentrate on their lives. Because if you really listen to the lyrics, you know, you just take away the beat, you'll see that's a story itself. You know, it's a story itself.
Well, we're putting that belt on the line for real. We're going to throw an event with real battle rappers, and if they want that belt, they're going to battle for it. And you know how some battles are debatables online? Yeah. You know, we throw them up there. That's why I got thousands of views, all crazy views.
But we're going to jump in that.
Yeah, but
it's a real belt.
What we're going to do is.
I made that belt.
It's going to be a clear winner. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They're going to walk away with that belt. That's what it's for. But that's what we're going to do. That's what we want to do, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to put them. You got bars. Yeah. We ain't going to sit back to watch the world decide. It's going to be a clear winner.
I'm not going to judge it. I'm going to have the audience judge it because I think we're supposed to stream it live. And I don't know how they do it, but they're going to do the points, and we're going to have real judges that's in the field.
Okay.
And they're going to sit there, and they're going to let it go.
I got three. I got three that I want. Murder Mook, they got to be Head Ice or Loaded Lux.
Okay.
I mean, I had Mook, and I had Ice come to my events too, but like the crowd, like she said, and like three major judges. I'm going to try to get one of them or two of them.
Yeah.
That's going to be crazy.
And that definitely will solidify it if you get one of them to come down to be the judge. So that's a good thing.
I want my song.
My son did battle.
He did a little battle. For a little while.
Yeah.
And he's on some other stuff. I mean, he still raps and stuff, but
he's
doing
a lot of political stuff.
But yeah. Mook, right? For that, I probably have Mook and Lux. And like Head Ice or something like that.
Because they're actually active in the culture.
Or Cortez.
Right now. No, that sounds dope. And the fact that they get the belt, we definitely get the belt in the building.
Well, I want to continue the belt. That belt, I designed it, and that one actually has a year because this segment, the whole web series is not over. But that belt will be put up. But each and every year there will be a new belt.
That's ridiculous. How you do a movie in like 6 months, right? And only filmed sometime. I don't know how she did that. She went to get somebody to do a logo for her. She ain't like what she heard. I got the logo. I'm doing the belt. I see the belt. I see the logo. I'm like, yo, she's a beast. I thought I was a beast. Forget about it.
I have six movies. Well, my son and I have six movies in 3 years. Listen, full features.
That's why I said don't be up here being humble. Been working extremely hard, and you know what I mean? And it's a good thing, you know, to, like I said, just to complete those projects and to continue to put out work. And you got more stuff that's getting ready to come out. So, you know, we definitely are following. And just for everyone at home who doesn't know, just let them know where they can get all of the movies at.
Oh, free? Oh, other than out in the street. Your local bootleg man.
Mm-hmm. No, don't go to the bootleg.
But no, well, all my movies are free. You can get them at www.streetlinevideo.com. You can watch everything we do. All the movies are online free. You can also check YouTube, Streetline Video. It's everywhere.
And you can check it out on www.shotimetv.com. I got the movie section just for the Streetline films. All of them lined up nice for you to see.
Nice.
You know?
And if someone does want to audition to be in the film, how can they contact you? How can they go about that?
They got to hit me up.
They got to hit him up, yeah. Okay. But you can also go through streetlinevideo@yahoo.com or show.
Or at SHOTIMETV, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Everything Showtime TV.
Okay.
You're the casting director now.
Yeah.
I have a couple of casting directors.
Look at him. I've been doing it for a while, though. But don't get it twisted, though. I watch this everything. You know, I watch everything. I watch your show. I see what y'all be doing. I never met you. I wanted to meet you in person.
Every time I see him,
he be chilling. And I'd be like, I'm going to go say what's up to him. And he'd be like...
Well, that's it. Listen, this is a family right here,
but
man.
But that's how you know. Like, that's how you know when because I do a lot of stuff. So I see everything, man. I see everything. So then when I see somebody that I respect and then I end up on a show or something like that, I'm like, yeah, that's me. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah.
Well, that's good thing, man. That's what family does, and we're going to continue to support Vera, Showtime, Streetline. We're going to continue to support you guys. And, you know, whenever something is new coming out, all you got to do is send it over, and we'll play a little trailer for y'all, and we'll promote it for you guys, because that's what we do. Really quick, if you guys are watching at home, make sure you guys check us out on the web, realfansrealtalk.com, Facebook.com/realfansrealtalk, Twitter, Instagram, @realfansrealtalk, and make sure you guys subscribe to the YouTube channel, youtube.com/forthefansproductions, just in case you was doing something, and I don't know why you would not be here on your couch watching TV on a Thursday night, but if you wasn't, this interview will be up on the YouTube channel, so you can still catch it again, or if you just want to watch it again, because, you know, Vera's here, Showtime is here, so you might want to see them again a couple more times. Watch it 4 or 5 times, you know, and then, you know, and we're gonna be keep rocking and keep doing what we're doing. We're going to show you guys one more clip from Pressed, and then when we come back, Ladybug is going to join us out here as well. Because I just got a text, an old school beeper, they paged me and said, yo, where's Ladybug at? We haven't seen her yet today. We want to know what's going on.
It's a short video, yeah. So you don't have to wait too much longer for Ladybug. Ladybug has a little movie debut too. Maybe you'll check that out and see if you can cast her on something future for Streetline.
But y'all better get on YouTube and make sure y'all watch Press, because it is good. And y'all better, and watch Chicken. Okay, shout out to my main man, Audie. Okay, she got a whole collection of movies that you should be watching. Just hit that YouTube channel up, Streetline Video, all right? And support, man, because when people is doing things and people are working, and when people are giving opportunities to people, you got to support that. We need to be supportive of each other. So y'all go check that out, and we're going to run this video, and when we come back, Ladybug's going to be joining us.
What's up, show?
Yo, we gotta end this fucking project, yo. Niggas is getting killed, a lot of shit going on. Yo, listen.
End it? The industry is buzzing right now. My stock just went up. We're not ending it. We're gonna take it even further, actually. And up the pot to 1 million. Hell, even more. We're gonna make a reality show of this thing.
Well, you have to find somebody else. All right? Another nigga, because you know what? I fucking quit.
Quit? How's your dad doing? He's still over on Walton Avenue? What about your mom? She's still over in Betsy Nursing Home? We wouldn't want anything to happen to them now, would we, Sho? I'm watching you, Sho. Go out there and do your job.
That was hot.
I ain't never seen Statman get down like that.
Before. I know.
I got a little nervous. I'm like, yo, Statman, you gotta chill, man. Come on.
Clutching my pearls.
You need your meetings or something that morning, man. You was going in right there, yo. I'm Statman, I'm proud of you, man. I see what you're doing out there, man. That was just crazy. Oh my goodness, yo. You guys did an amazing job with the project, and oh man, I'm looking forward to seeing the next installment of this. So don't forget, guys, it's Pressed. Go on YouTube, hit up Streetline, watch that movie, tell your friend to tell a friend to tell a friend, and then you might get lucky enough to maybe meet Vera and get into one of her projects, or holler at Showtime since he's the actor, you know, casting director. He got about 8 jobs, you know, that he do on the project. So holler at one of them and we're gonna get it in. But Ladybug, what's going on?
Hey, what's going on? Nice to meet you guys. I'm definitely a fan of the project. It's awesome. I just want to say thank you, guys. I have to say a public thank you real quick. Everybody that supported the pregame 1-year anniversary, Real Fans, Real Talk was there. So it was definitely an amazing event. So I want to say on behalf of the pregame, thank you to everybody that attended, performed, and just supported us throughout the year. So back on to my rumor mill. You know, I have to go into Antonio Brown. Now, you know, I feel like it was harmless. But the way social media is, you have to be careful. You know, he did apologize for recently going on Facebook Live, and basically after their win, they were just, you know, he was in the locker room, just, you know, on Facebook Live, just cheering on in his excitement, you know, just happy that he won. And basically that violates the league rules, so he is going to be penalized for that. So, you know, how do you guys feel? Like, you know, people like to celebrate moments. Like, I had the, you know, anniversary party, like I said, and I was on Instagram Live and stuff like that. But I guess when you're in a franchise and you sign contracts.
And the coach didn't just tell you 5 minutes before you did that, no videos or no social media right now.
You know, so it slips your mind.
I think it's a little bit different.
It didn't slip his mind.
Come on. So we can't get no benefit of the doubt in this.
We're not supposed to be doing this, but I'm going to us anyway. I believe he did say that in the video.
I didn't hear that. You know, I don't
recall. Team rules and it's against NFL rules. And
I don't recall.
You know,
it's company protocol and procedures.
Rules are rules, I mean, but I mean,
Mike Tomlin,
am I mad at him? No.
We can't dance no more.
What if he's still in the locker room on Facebook Live and someone comes out the shower hanging out with his wang out?
People
and then that goes on Facebook Live, and that represents the Steelers.
Yeah. Well, oh my gosh, there was a rapper that just did that. There's other athletes that do that just for media purposes. Well,
yeah, but you know what? Like,
but you know what?
This the fans don't mind it, because you know, especially if you're a fan of that team, you want to kind of see, you know, you want to be around that, especially after coming off a tough playoff win, so you want to be a part of that. But as far as the league, you know, and the team, you know, Mike Tomlin barked on him.
Yeah, he came out, you know, at the press conference. You know, the coaches were upset. You know, he did publicly apologize.
He's making enough to afford the fine, so he'll be all right.
But it's called being brand. You have to be brand. No matter what, you're attached to an entity. Yeah. You as an individual is still, that's like me being disrespectful at a Streetline event, and I'm one of the actors.
Yeah, that's what sucks about being in the public.
Gotta be responsible.
You know, even Obama said recently, like, he curses behind closed doors. He does all that behind closed doors, but he can't do that because he's the face of America.
Aren't you? But you should be used to it.
No. That's why I don't think, that's why I think I still need potential, because I make a lot of mistakes. I apologize a lot. I own up to mine. But, you know, my brand is working. I'm a brand in progress, so I'm not mad at
so
that.
Humble. Yeah, but I'm just saying.
I'm humble yet hungry. You know, that's my slogan.
No, but everybody watches. Trust
they
me.
They do, and I appreciate it.
They won't
that.
Like it, but they'll watch it.
So, like, the whole, like, situation, like, with, the, you know, the tables and stuff like that kind of thing there. But, you know, it happens, so it's all
but
good.
You see, they always bring it up. So, you see, as much as you want to be branded, you will always be remembered for something, right? So, as good as Ladybug could be, she's remembered for dancing on tables.
$15,000?
Cool. I accept it. I would never pay $18,000 for a fine if I stand on the table, though.
That's true.
That might make you me good. Stop standing on tables.
They're just going to put your picture
unless
so you
I make
can't come
those
back
figures,
to this
like
establishment.
Unless I make those figures where I can say $18,000, I pay, you know, I prepay for tomorrow because I'm going to stand on that tomorrow.
There too. You go.
Maybe. But, you know, I'm not there yet, so we're not going to do that.
That goes right. back into the visuals, how people remember everything you do.
That is true.
But she's never actually danced on a table.
But they, see, but the rumor could, see, but
we
that
could
just take
say
it
that,
further than
you know,
anything.
Behind closed
yeah,
doors.
I'm going to start going on YouTube and looking. She says she was on a table.
And I bet you a lot of
hello.
People are doing that now. It's over.
It's in the comments on
I
the YouTube.
I tried to clear the air there and put the truth out there, but nobody believes it anyway.
They don't want to know the truth, that man. They like the story.
Anyway.
Yeah,
you can't handle the truth.
So talking about movies, talking about projects, that actually, you know, a lot of movies are coming out this year. They're coming out with like Power Rangers, all these different
you
movies.
You saw that the new trailer came out today.
Do you
I was
see?
I screamed like a I screamed
Air
like
five.
A yes, I screamed Air like a five. They said this is a Caucasian woman screaming. I said, I'm sorry, it was me.
Oh, no.
I waited like 5 months for this trailer.
So as these movies are coming out, they're talking about making a remake of White Men Can't Jump. So now these people are coming in trying to make a team and, you know, go into this project. And actually, Blake Griffin is, you know, taking his production producer skills and trying to bring that in the forefront of the remake. Mm. So, you know, that's actually getting a lot of buzz now because they're like, you know,
as
he's
long
funny.
As,
he doesn't
Blake Griffin isn't playing Woody Harrelson.
He is not. That was the misconception. When right, people thought they was bringing him and the movie together, they're like, oh my gosh, he's going to play that? No, he's not. He's actually going to step
that's
back,
a good thing.
Go into producing and, you know,
even though Blake Griffin actually can act, like he does really well in
not,
in the commercials.
Skits
yeah. like
a lot
that.
Of
I don't want to see him playing Billy.
Yeah, because
that.
That's not Woody Harrelson that you're not buying that he could get up there.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Dunk, like, that was the whole.
You know, Blake
point.
Can.
So yeah, it defeats.
Do we
that.
Really want to see White Man Can't Jump?
The remake?
I don't know. I guess the generation thing.
Because
how do you say White Man Can't Jump now on these days when you have Barry who won the. Dunk contest.
I'm saying. I guess
no free throw line like Jordan.
See, back then it was a stigma, but now the white people are being disrespectful. Dunking with, you know, they're doing the mannequin challenge while they dunk.
Yeah,
you know,
it's
so
crazy.
I don't know, but that's definitely in the works. But you know,
who gonna play Rosie Perez character? Because that's what I need to see about. And then see
I don't
that.
Know.
That's
I'm not
go
sure.
Down.
Wesley
I'm gonna keep up on
dogs.
Everything.
Gonna play that? All right.
I'm gonna keep up on
keep
that because I actually do like that movie. So the remake, you know, I like to make sure they do it right.
Okay.
As much as I can't talk to them, you know, from the outside, I yell at the TV like, no, don't put that person.
Go
no.
on Twitter.
So. No,
start a poll.
That's what Twitter's for.
I know. I'm a
hashtag.
I'm a brand in progress because you're not supposed to get in your feelings on Twitter and people say the wrong things.
Oh, they
and
do.
I do. Not in 140 characters. It's just not
oh
enough for me. Can't do it. Anyway,
oh,
talking about you know social media and joking and trolling as they say, Tony Romo was recently trolled by EA Sports with the claim saying the only way you'll see the Super Bowl is on Madden 17.
Wow, that's disrespectful.
That was cold.
That's disrespectful.
Not that I'm a fan of Tony Romo, but that's cold.
And that's EA Sports. So, you know, that's that franchise.
I mean,
they say that's their
brand. They're right. You know, I agree with it, right? But that's cold, Joe, for y'all to just say that.
Oh, man.
That's crazy.
So,
I love
so,
Madden even more now. That just that,
I'm just saying EA Sports,
like
that's funny.
The
EA
Sports,
yeah, I'm about to go back and play.
You get a thumbs up on EA Sports. That was that's too much.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
See?
Yep.
And you know that. So the fact they said that, it's like, oh, you remember. See, like, what you remember them for. It's just how
I'm
going to
remember
works.
Them for this now.
And you see, you're going to remember them. So it's definitely great.
Damn.
So, yeah, those are my little rumors for the week. Make sure you guys check me out, realfansworldtalk.com. And also, quick shout-outs, Mr. Pascal. He made me a special custom Ladybug hat.
That's fire.
And I am a 90s kid. If you don't know who this is, Google A Bug's Life. And you'll know, this is the character Francis, and it was definitely somebody that resonated with me. I don't know why, I guess because I'm a tomboy. So definitely thank you, Mr. Pascal. RP Gallery is his Instagram. And yeah, check me out.
So y'all already talked about Chris Brown and Soulja Boy arguing.
We spoke about it last week.
They put up the video.
Yeah, put up the video of the week workout.
And we'll talk about it more as the, you know, when it comes down, and if they actually do have the fight, we'll be talking about it.
I want to see the promo. I want to see the promo.
I had so much money involved.
We had the promo last week. That was the promo.
Yeah,
No.
Soulja Boy,
he didn't official promo. Not that. Him swatting flies promo.
That's,
I don't know what that
that's
was.
That's the promo. Him swatting the flies one up.
I need the money team logo somewhere. I need to see this really happen.
The bets are already out in the streets.
Shout out
50.
Shout out to my guy 50.
Definitely.
Yeah, this is what I'm saying. People are putting their hands on in
everything.
Pie.
He's out there.
Everyone.
Anybody that got an issue, he's trying to capitalize.
I need an official marketing, official promo. I need that. That's what I'm waiting for.
Well, we're going to see. Oh, we got to mention this. MLB Hall of Fame, Tim Raines, Jeff Bagwell, and Pudge Rodriguez will be the newest members of the Major League Baseball Hall of Fame. So congratulations to those guys.
How do you remember all this stuff?
Steroid rumors surrounding
them. I don't even know. It just comes in.
How he does it.
Well, listen, I mean, Barry and Roger are still on the card. They're getting closer. They're getting a little closer every year. Yep. I think Barry was at 53% of the votes. And Roger Clemens is at like 54% of the votes right now. So they're doing enough to stay on the ballot. And hopefully, I mean, I really want to see Barry get into the Hall of Fame. Since technically, he didn't really test positive. He didn't have a test that came back positive. So technically, he should still be good to go. But since his name was, you know, all up in there, you know, they're not trying to let my man Barry get into the Hall of Fame.
I like how you mentioned the memory thing, because John Starks complimented me that too when I was interviewing him for like 40 minutes straight. And we have no teleprompter here. Yeah. And I like the fact that you asked us that question on the live show, because we don't
always
use teleprompters.
The stats is crazy. I'm like, damn. And I got one more question. Like, do y'all set this up every time y'all come out every show?
Sometimes it's different. We just move things around. Because
it was just bothering us. So let me just ask them. Like, does this stuff stay the same way that y'all
inquiring lines? You want to know. And fan mail at realfansrealtalk.com if you have any other fan mail questions. Yeah.
No, we change it up every week. Or if somebody sends us something over, or like we see, we got these are autographed, these boxing gloves here. So whenever we added we have the Yankees? Yeah, the Yankees, we just got that recently, not too long ago, the Yankee helmet right there. So
that's from the stadium.
Up. Yeah, that's actually from the stadium.
It used to be filled with nachos.
Yeah, it was. But I definitely took them nachos and you know, did some things, and then now we good. Now we keep it on the set with us, though. But listen, we're going to get into the final thought segment of the show. So Showtime, we're going to start off with you, man. What you want to just talk to the people, man?
Okay, which camera I look at?
Well, that one. Yeah, you got look 25 seconds. So.
Showtime, at Showtime TV, at Shotime TV, on everything media. Got the hottest people in the game in front of my camera, all the celebrities, all the shows that's popping, which I'm on right now. Just follow me, Streetline Video. You're going to forever see me in a Streetline film, as usual. That's all I got to say.
Vera?
All I have to say is learn to be humble. When someone throws you a bone, there's no catches other than you becoming famous, give back. Remember to love on set. Remember that the people you're down with, the ones that's near you and helping you with your lines, remember them, because when it's over, it's over. But you can always go back to that memory and have fun with them, and you can catch me on streetlinevideo.com.
All right, and I'm just going to give a universal one for myself, Ladybug and Statman. Mm-hmm. Support those people in our communities that's working and giving out opportunities. We got to continue to support that. Thank you so much, Vera. Showtime. Make sure y'all check out Pressed for myself, Mark the Statman, Skevich, Ladybug. We will see you guys next week right here.
Good night, everyone.
He took my move. He did.
That's trademarked. That's trademarked.
RealFansRealTalk.com, where Arthur Dom is Trick Young and Intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan, I get all my facts from my bro Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics, RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Is Jeremy Lin hurt?
Well,
log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest, I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives, even tell a neighbor, tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda.